So far, we've discussed the numerical methods to solve the ODE initial value problem, the differential equation where you specify initial conditions at some initial time, say, and then you march the solution forward. There's another class of differential equations that are called boundary value problems. And there's a method called the shooting method that can be used to solve the boundary value problem. So let me first set up what is a boundary value problem, and then go through what the shooting method is. And then at the very end of this video, I'll explain to you why the method has this name, this interesting name called shooting. So we're looking to solve then a boundary value problem. Say it's a second order differential equation, d squared y dx squared, which is equal to some function of x and y and dy dx. By a boundary value problem, what we're given is that we know the value of y at some initial x value, x naught. So this is equal to y naught. So that's given. And we know the value of y at some final value of x, xf, and that's equal to yf, and that's also given, okay? So it's called a two-point boundary value problem because the values of y are given at the boundary of the domain. The domain goes from x naught to xf. Okay, if we were going to use ODE 45 to solve this problem, we would write it as a system of first-order differential equations. So we would break this up into two first-order equations. So we would have dy dx, and we can call that a new variable z. And then we would have dz dx, and we can that's then equal to d squared y dx squared, and that would be a function of x, y, and dy dx, which is z, and x, y, and z. Okay? So we write our second order differential equation as a system of first order equations. If we wanted to solve a system of first order equations using ODE 45, we would need two initial conditions. So here we would need y at the value of x naught equals y naught. This is known, right? This is known. But to solve the z equation, we would need to know z at the value of x naught. But z at the value of x naught is dy dx at the value of x naught. That's not known, right? In the two-point boundary value problem, we don't know dy dx at x naught. So we're going to call this cosi. And cosi then is unknown. Okay? So our goal here is to determine the value of cosi. Our constraint is that y of xf is supposed to equal to yf. Okay? So how do we do that? So we define a function. So we define some f, capital F function, which is a function of cosi. And how do we define that? We define f of cosi. So remember, cosi is the initial value of z. We define f of cosi equal to the value of y we get at xf after we integrate the differential equation using these two initial conditions minus the value we want y to be at xf, which is y sub f, okay? Our goal here then is to find the zero of capital F. We want to find cosi such that, st, such that f of cosi equals zero, right? We want the integration of the differential equation from x equals x naught to xf to result in the value yf. f solving cosi such that f of cosi equals 0, this is a root finding problem, right? Which we know how to solve. Okay. Let me draw a picture so it will become more clear how this works. Okay, so here's a picture. This is our x. This is our y. This is x naught. Let's put x naught here. This is xf. And let's draw a line at xf. Okay, so what are we trying to solve? We're trying to solve for y by solving this differential equation. We know two values. We know here, that's y at x naught, that's y naught. We know a value, say here, that's y at xf, that's y sub f. That's the two-point boundary value problem. And then we know that y of x has to satisfy this differential equation. Okay, satisfy this differential equation. So the shooting method then is a root finding problem. We start off with some value of cosi. Remember that cosi is z at x naught. Z of x naught is dy dx at x naught. So the value of cosi then is the slope of the y function at x equals x naught. So say our initial value for cosi may have a slope that looks like this, right? And then we solve the differential equation. We solve it, and maybe we end up over here, right? So we missed the value y of xf equals yf. So f cosi is not 0 here. Here, f cosi would be positive, right? Y of xf up here is larger than yf. Okay, this is called shooting, right? This step is called shooting. We aim the gun, that's the slope. We shoot the gun, that's solving the differential equation. And we end up at the y value at x equals xf. The target is here, we miss the target. Our root finding routine then will then be an iteration routine. We start with a value of cosi. We get something that is not 0. Our root finding routine will then say, I'll try another value of cosi. Here, maybe it will be a lower one, right? That might be our second slope that we try. We shoot again. We solve the differential equation. And maybe we end up here. Okay, so we missed again. So now our root finding routine has these two pieces of information. And then it will say, okay, try another value of cosi. Okay? It turns out if this is a linear equation, the third value is a charm and it will give you the exact solution. If it's a nonlinear equation, you might have to have several iterations. But let's say that it's a linear equation. The third shot is a charm. The root finding routine will say, okay, try this value. And then we have this slope and we integrate forward and we hit the solution within some error tolerance. This curve, this final curve here, is what we're trying to find. We're trying to solve the differential equation. All three of these curves solve the differential equation, but we also want to solve the two-point boundary conditions, y of x naught equals y naught. That's where we start. We always solve that. But y of xf equals yf. Our third try here solves that boundary condition, and that's our solution. So let me review this shooting method. The idea then is we have a root finding routine. We're trying to find the zero of this capital F. The zero, the function capital F, is a special type of function which we've never seen before. It's a function where you integrate a differential equation, second order differential equation, from x naught to xf using y of x naught equals y naught and y and dy dx at x naught equal to cosi. That's our variable here, cosi. So y of xf is the integration of a differential equation, and we subtract from that yf, which is the value that we want y of xf to achieve. This is our function of cosi. Okay, so we have our outer loop is going to be our root finding iteration, and our inner loop then is going to be our solution of the differential equation. Both the outer loop and the inner loop are actually done in MATLAB, the point being that we're using F0 for our root finding routine, and we're using ODE 45 for our differential integration routine. Okay, you have a very fun reading problem to do that will implement the shooting method in MATLAB. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.